Panasonic just updated its Tether app for live streaming software. This allows Lumix cameras to be a source for your video conferencing apps like Zoom and Skype, and also for live streaming without any graphic overlays. Let's get into it.
Delivering informative capability-based reviews and tutorials on camera gear, filming techniques, and content creation.
Hi, I'm Simon, and this is The Ordinary Filmmaker. If you're new here, subscribe to get notification of new videos as they come out. And all the links to everything I talk about in this video, including gear discussed, are placed in the description down below. Canon and Fuji already released beta software to use their cameras for video conferencing. Well, now Panasonic has done the same. Like Canon, Panasonic streaming software is offered as beta and is still being developed. This means they're still working on it and there are bugs to be fixed. Panasonic says that the beta software program for Windows is derived from their conventional Lumix Tether software with an additional display option for live streaming purposes. It may help user convenience in the growing self-streaming opportunities. Well done, Panasonic. I wish Canon would do the same for their Mac software. This allows your Panasonic supported camera to live stream and not just use it for video conferencing software. Panasonic says the Tether software is compatible with these cameras, the GH5, GH5S, G9, and all S1 cameras. I was going to say all S1H cameras. So all S1 cameras include the S1, the S1R, and the recently released S1H. Now, if you have a camera that isn't supported, try out the software and let us know if it works. We did find that Canon software worked with way more cameras than they advertised, and that the Windows software was far more capable than the later released Mac software, allowing Canon cameras to work with OBS, a live streaming package. And just like Canon, no Mac version is available on first release. There wasn't even any mention of a Mac version, but I would expect one to be in development. The Tether software is compatible with Windows 10. It requires USB 3.0 or higher, and is relatively low impact, requiring 100 megabytes of disk space and a 1 gigahertz processor. That's it for now. This is just a short announcement keeping you informed on the Camera News Network, or at least that's what some of you are calling me. Thanks for watching The Ordinary Filmmaker. We'll see you again soon.
Thank you for watching The Ordinary Filmmaker. All equipment used and notes are placed in the description box, show more box, or down arrow thingy next to the title on the mobile app.